Greetings world. We are anonymous. We do not forgive, we do not forget. Expect us. Physicians and other health workers in Alberta have the ability to look up patients' medical information in Alberta's Netcare system, leading to one victim furious over health record snooping, and wants changes to Alberta's prosecution limit. Without his knowledge, as he was laying in a hospital bed trying to recover, the wife of a longtime friend went into the province's electronic health database to look up his private medical information. He was not one of her patients, though she worked in a doctor's office, she had no medical reason to view his files. It seems she pried only because she was curious. While the illness eventually subsided, it's been much harder for him to rid himself of the shame and anger ignited by the intrusion. Since learning last year of the unauthorized access, the Stettler resident has been on a quest for justice, but his efforts to get the issue resolved have proved largely futile. Following an investigation that took close to 10 months, the Office of the Information and Privacy Commissioner ruled that even though an invasion had clearly occurred, little could be done due to Alberta rules that prohibit prosecutions more than 2 years after a breach. That May ruling has left him even more enraged, not just at Commissioner's office for prolonging an investigation that had no chance of success, but also at the law that makes it impossible for him to seek justice for a violation he didn't know about until it was too late. It's a barrier he feels could hurt other Albertans, as increasing attention on digital security could soon prompt more and more people to ask about the protection of their medical records, and who might be looking at them. He'd like the government to change their idiotic rules and regulations, and stated that he wants to see something happen for everything he has been put through, because he doesn't want the next person having to deal with what he has dealt with. His grievance is centered on the Health Information Act, which sets the rules on how medical information should be collected, protected, used, and shared. Amendments to the Act were made in 2006 that largely focused on clarifying when a patient's medical information could be disclosed to police, but also introduced new fines as well as a new statute of limitations. A prosecution under this Act may be commenced within 2 years after the commission of the alleged offence, but not afterwards, which was an increase from the previous 6-month limitation period. In this case, he fell seriously ill in early 2014 and required several weeks in hospital, followed by a long recovery at home. It wasn't until the spring of 2017 after he started to hear chatter from acquaintances speculating on his health that he decided to ask who had access to his medical files. Under provincial law, Albertans have the right to request an audit log that shows who has viewed their health records in Albertan Netcare. When the patient in this matter received a copy of his logs, it clearly showed two entries by his friend's wife on February 12, 2014, while she was working as an assistant at a private doctor's office in Smoky Lake. Among the records she viewed were discharge summaries that featured detailed descriptions of his illness, treatment plan, and medications. At the time of the breach, she was the designated privacy officer for the doctor's office. The day after learning about the violation is when he made an official complaint to the provincial privacy commissioner's office. The fact the 2-year limit had already expired should have been immediately obvious to the investigator assigned by the commissioner, yet this was not explained or even mentioned. Instead, the official proceeded with a lengthy investigation, raising his hopes that he might eventually see some punishment imposed for the invasion of privacy. The case needed 3 extensions before finally wrapping up in May, when sure enough the investigator ruled no prosecution was possible because the statute of limitations had passed before the breach was discovered. This is understandably frustrating for the complainant, the investigator wrote in his decision. The report went on to make a handful of recommendations to the Smoky Lake doctor, including that he continue privacy training efforts with his employees, have staff sign confidentiality agreements, and also consider periodic audits of his workers' use of Netcare. However, the investigator also concluded the doctor already had reasonable privacy safeguards in place. Unfortunately, this appears to be a case of a rogue employee, since the woman had already left Smoky Lake for a job with Alberta Health Services, the doctor couldn't fire or suspend her. In a related investigation, the commissioner's office also looked at what actions had been taken by Alberta Health Services, the woman's new employer. That investigation found the health authority had interviewed the woman about the breach, and conducted an audit of all her Netcare activity that found no further violations, since the invasion of the records occurred before the woman was hired by the health authority. AHS decided it couldn't take any action against her. She continues to work for AHS and uses Netcare as part of her duties. The invasion of privacy has been devastating to his patients' mental and physical health. He lives in fear that people know more about him than they should know, and so he is literally afraid to walk down the street. Making matters worse has been the failure of efforts to see his intruder punished, The commissioner's office appears to have mishandled the investigation by failing to emphasize to him at the start that no prosecution could happen. His situation is not the only recent case in which the two-year limit played a role. Last month, a Fox Creek nurse was fined $3,000 after pleading guilty to improperly accessing the health information of two people several times between the fall of 2015 and the summer of 2016. However, numerous other breaches from earlier times back to 2013 couldn't be prosecuted because the limitation period had expired. The health minister wasn't available for an interview, but a statement emailed on her behalf said the health ministry will continue to explore ways to strengthen protection for Albertans' personal health information. The statement did not specifically answer whether a change to the two-year limit might be contemplated. However, additional information sent by the ministry noted that 2 years is the prosecution boundary enshrined in other Alberta legislation and is also the standard for civil litigation. As for other provinces, there appears to be significant differences. Manitoba's health information legislation contains a two-year limit identical to Alberta's, while Saskatchewan's limit kicks in from the point when a breach is discovered. In Ontario, there is no limitation period. In BC, it's currently not an offence to snoop into someone's medical information, though that province's privacy commissioner is hoping to see the law changed. It is a violation for a public sector worker to inappropriately disclose someone's private information. That carries a 1-year statute of limitations applied from the time the offence occurred, although B.C.'s Minister of Citizen Services is allowed to extend it. A spokesman for the Alberta Commissioner's Office said he couldn't comment on the case, but noted the office's website contains plenty of information for potential complainants on what the office can and can't do. This includes warnings that the office can't act as an advocate or provide legal advice, and that investigations typically take several months. Also noted that on August 31, new regulations come into effect that will require health custodians such as doctors' offices and AHS to report all privacy breaches to patients if it is deemed they face a risk of harm. It is likely the new regulations will increase Albertans' awareness of privacy risks, which in turn could result in more people asking for their Netcare logs and making complaints to the commissioner's office. Staff who work with medical records are now subject to mandatory privacy training as well as audits of their Netcare use, and AHS regularly conducts risk assessments of its IT systems, the health authority said. Despite those safeguards, the security of the system still depends to some degree on the good behavior of the professionals who use it. And in those rare cases when someone views information they have no business viewing, it seems unfair for the government to impose barriers to victims seeking justice. This doesn't just happen in Alberta. Medical record snooping happens everywhere, with many different laws in place about them. We are anonymous. We do not forgive, we do not forget. Expect us.